In this video, you will learn what pivoting is and how to create a pivot table in the Analytics platform. Let's jump into it. First, let's take a look at some example use cases where pivoting is helpful. Here you have a dataset that contains daily weather information from different cities over the course of 1 year. In the pivot table, each cell quantifies the total sum of sunshine hours for each city, here in the column headers, in each month, here in the rows. In the second example, you have a dataset containing sales information, country, purchase order date, and purchase order value. In the pivot table, each cell quantifies the average purchase order value for each country in each month. The third example includes once again sales data. You want to know the number of times each product has been purchased in the online and on-site stores. In the pivot table, you want to report the product numbers in the rows and the sort types in the columns. Each cell contains the total number of times a particular product has been purchased in that store type. Using the pivot node in KNIME Analytics platform, it is easy to create this kind of aggregated tables. The different values of one column becomes unique rows, and the different values of another column becomes column headers. In addition, an aggregation method is applied to a third column. Every time you create a pivot table, you have to define which column to use to generate the rows, which column to use to generate the column headers, and which column to use to apply the aggregation method. The column product number is the group column. This means the values in this column generate the rows in the pivot table. The store type column is the pivot column. This means the values in this column generate the column headers in the pivot table. Quantity is the column chosen for the aggregation, and the aggregation method is sum. Now, let's do that in KNIME Analytics platform. The columns that you're interested in are the columns product number, store type, and quantity. Open the configuration of the pivot node. Do you remember the three options group, pivot, and aggregate? Here, you can see that for each option, you have one tab. In the groups tab, you can define the rows in the pivot table. In this example, each value in the product number column produces one row in the pivot table. Therefore, include this column in the group columns. The pivot table will have two columns, one for the online and one for the on-site store. Include the column store type in the pivot columns. Under the include and exclude fields in the pivot tab, there is also an option that allows missing values to generate their own pivot column. You have now defined the column headers and the rows of the pivot table. Next, define the aggregation column and the aggregation method in the manual aggregation tab. Like the group by node, the pivot node offers many aggregation methods, for example count, mean, percent, and sum. If the meaning of some of the aggregation methods is not clear, you can find a handy explanation in the description tab. In this example, you want to compute the number of times an item has been purchased for each store type. In practice, this means that you want to sum the value quantity in these groups. Select the quantity column as the aggregation column and sum as the aggregation method. In addition, you can define some more advanced settings in the lower part of the configuration dialog. Using these two menus, you can define the column names and the pivot table. In the first menu, select if you want to include the pivot column value and the aggregation method name, or only the pivot column value. In the second menu, select how the aggregation method name is going to appear, whether it should be included in the column names or not. Execute the node and have a look at the output. In the first output table, you can see the expected pivot table. Note that if a combination of product and store type is not present, the node outputs a missing value. In addition to the pivot table, the node has two other output tables. The second output table shows the group totals, that is, the totals by row. The third output table shows the pivot totals, that is, the total by columns. In this video, you have learned what pivoting is and how to create a pivot table in KNIME Analytics platform.